I slice the amniotic fluid of the pregnant silence. It leaked, drip dropped, and wet the empty floor. Enough was enough. I'd have to mop this up and wring the truth out, no matter how much it hurt. Sitting across the table from my grandmother, hazel eyes burned into me like laser lights. She tilted her neck and her lips fell apart in a gape. She let the words hang in the air. They didn't need to be said with a dramatic flair. Me and my twin sister are a product of rape. But we learnt the truth from my mama before her passing. Back in her day, blanc and noir didn't mix to create a grey scale, and it was a crime for a black man to love a white woman. So she told her papa what he wanted to hear so not to be shunned from the family flock. I'd rather be a black sheep any day than be responsible for the persecution and death of the man that I love. My grandmother tilted her head in between that space of agreeing and disagreeing. Defense rose from the fire and furnace of her belly and smoked on her cheeks. That's easy to say, but we never lived in my mama's day. I sat back in my chair as if to say, I won't say another word, just give me the story. I came out the colour of barely burnt caramel, and she clotted cream. So ended fairness and unity's dream in this household. The way she swore her shoulders and lifted her neck, I knew trouble had made my grandmother proud. Oh my god, that's the first time that's happened. give me a step, coat.
Does it rhyme with shit?
Why? I wish. This is why writing comes in handy. You got a photo line. Damn it. that's not coming back to me, so I'm going to switch to another porn movie.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
Okay.
Freestyle.
Yeah, no, I can't do that.
Yeah.
This one's a shorty. It's